Alrighty, hey there, my name is Andy Silva. This is a recording for my Anatomy 1, Anatomy and Physiology number 1, for my critical assignment. For my presentation, I'm going to be presenting for the respiratory system, and particularly for the lungs. Alrighty, so the lungs. Okay. So the lungs are a major organ of the respiratory system. Then there's two, of course, and they're divided into sections or lobes. On the right lung, there's three lobes, and it's slightly larger than the left lung, which also has lobes. But this on this side, there's only going to be two lobes. It's going to be only the upper and lower lobe. So in this area of the lungs, it contains the heart, trachea, esophagus, and a bunch of many lymph nodes. They're covered by a protective membrane, also known as the pleura, and they're separated from the abdominal cavity by the muscular diaphragm. So, as you can see, there is the trachea, which conducts the air and leads it all the way to the bronchus, the primary bronchuses, which is the right primary and the left primary. There are also not here displayed on this picture, but there's also bronchioles and alveoli, which conduct the gas exchange. And on the left side, you can see that there is a little space for the heart, and that is why the right side is bigger than the left side. The right side lung is going to be bigger than the left side because of that space right there. Alrighty, so a little bit more info about the lungs. So it starts from the mouth to the trachea and then down to the primary bronchus where it leads the air. So the lungs are these pair of sponge-like air-filled organs, and they obtain air to conduct and use oxygen and produce a waste product and release carbon dioxide. And this is where the carbon dioxide leads off to the environment. So, like I stated before, there's two parts, there's two lungs, each side of the thorax. And as stated before as well, the trachea conducts the air into the lungs, and from there to the bronchus, and from the bronchus, it leads off into the bronchioles, which direct the oxygen into the alveoli. And the alveoli are the sacs that contain that oxygen, which make that gas exchange into carbon dioxide, which lets the person breathe out. Alrighty, so the recent medical diagnosis diagnoses it's primarily for chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, or COPD, which is a mixture of chronic bronchitis and emphysema. So this new form of treatment, which is named bronchoscopic lung volume reduction, or BLVR, this is conducted with a flexible catheter and a bronchoscope, and it's used to put many tiny valves in lungs, specifically, especially away from the diseased areas, or they connect so it reroutes those air sacs and those non-diseased areas so that you can have more of a relief and not as much shortness of breath. And it improves the efficacy of gas exchange and respiratory problems. Alrighty, and for our last slide here, the biblical perspective. So, all in all, we are in connection with God, through the earth and with God. As we breathe oxygen, which is created by plants and many other environmental plants, we use that oxygen to provide off our carbon dioxide. And carbon dioxide is taken by plants, which they need for photosynthesis. And we have this cycle, this chain that that God purposefully made and which connects us to our earth. So this new medical treatment, it helps us restore the ability to breathe with ease by disclosing those diseased parts of the lungs. And that disease is mostly caused by just plain smoking. The most common is smoking, but it's mainly for breathing matter that is not supposed to be there, you know. And the main design for God, for our lungs, is to just breathe normally, to breathe in through the sacs, to completely successfully get that gas exchange in our alveoli or through the air sacs, and to breathe it out. But since in cases where people have this disease or many diseases of the lungs, either by through smoking or through drugs or anything like that, or injuries as well, we can use this BLVR as a treatment and, hopefully make other people suffer less than they have to. And usually the design that replaces it from, God's view is it just replaces the design of breathing by connecting and shutting off diseased parts through the use of a bronchoscope, sorry, and a flexible catheter that has a camera. One passage that I really like, it starts on Genesis 2:7. He states, "Then the Lord God formed the man of dust from the ground and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and the man became a living creature." It is self-evident that we can see here that, if it wasn't for God, we wouldn't be able to breathe. We wouldn't be able to do our daily activities, see our loved ones. God just created this atmosphere for us to go ahead and be in this cycle with God's earth and God's vision, God's image, of course, all in all. And that concludes my presentation. I hope you enjoyed it, and thank you so much for sticking by. Thank you.